Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, welcome. I am Monique and today we're going to talk about my piercing history. So as you guys know, I have a lot of ear piercings here, you know, a lot of piercings in general. Most of my ear piercings were done last year, but I did get a few throughout my years as obviously I grew up. So I just wanted to come here and basically give y'all the scoop on, you know, getting holes in your body. So what I did was I put a list on my phone of like all the piercings that I've had, when I got them, and if I can find a picture, I will leave them somewhere around here so that y'all can see how the piercing looked when I had it. So if you see me looking at my phone, you know. The first piercing I want to talk about is actually going to be my low piercing that I obviously got when I was like a baby. I don't even remember the pain or anything. When I got my second two done, I got these done with an actual needle instead of just the gun, so I figured the gun is probably going to be like less painful, although these weren't painful. So anyways, around 2012 I got my cartilage pierced, and I got that done with a gun at Walmart. It didn't hurt, it wasn't painful, didn't take a long time to heal. I had to put that little cleaner, like I think it was like a wound cleaner that Walmart gives you or that you pay for when you get piercings, and I just put that in, rotated it around kind of like they tell you to do. It shattered my cartilage. It's literally like a permanent hole in my ear. So after that, in 2016, I went to New Orleans and I wanted venom bites, but the guy didn't know what I was talking about, and so I showed him a picture. It was just like the picture of the top of the tongue, so he thought I wanted a surface piercing, and that's what he gave me on my tongue. And it didn't hurt, it wasn't painful. The only thing that happened is when it started to like swell up, he put such a small bar in it to like of a scoop or whatever that my tongue started to go over it, and I was like, nah, 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 buddy, it's not gonna happen this way. So I took it out and just longed for the venom bite piercing that I wanted. So in 2017, I got my initial like nose piercings, because at the end of the day I already knew that I wanted two nose rings. It didn't look bad, but it definitely looked bad for me, like on me, you know. I looked freaking crazy and my nose was too wide, like one piercing over here, then one piercing like a mile away. It was looking ridiculous. One of them actually got a bump on it. I think it was the one with the hoop, because I had one with a hoop and one with a stud, and the one with the hoop actually got a bump on it. And I just completely freaked out. I thought I was infected. I thought I was gonna die. So I took that one out, and then I couldn't take the screw nose ring out of my other side, and that one started to get a bump on it. So then it was just like, okay, bro, like I am literally going to die. Like I'm going to pull it out of my nose. I'm gonna have this big hole in my nose. It's gonna look crazy. But the pain for that piercing was very minimal. Your eyes do water like severely. Like a bitch was in tears, but not because of pain, because I guess it just messes with your sinuses. So there was that. So in 2018, I got my venom bites exactly how I wanted them. I went to a professional piercer, and I was scared for my fucking life, because venom bites are not a piercing that you can just go to anybody and get. You have to actually do your research, actually like get into like make sure that this is exactly what you want, because your tongue has two major veins in it, or two major arteries. I'm not sure what the term is anymore, because I did my research like years and years ago, but it has two major little things that, you know, you could bleed out and die, you can get paralyzed, stuff like that. Like a lot can happen if it's pierced incorrectly. And so I went into this piercing shop in the town over next to mine, and I literally went to the piercer and I'm just like, hey girl, like I want venom bites. And then they're like, oh well, I don't do those, but my friend so-and-so does. Wait until she came in, and literally she's like, yeah, I've done venom bites like like forever, like no problem, no worries. And your girl was just literally sitting here worrying like fuck. Like I was just like, okay, well look at the underneath of my tongue. Like look at the, like, you know, look at the veins, look at the arteries, whatever the case is. I was like, make sure they're straight, but make sure they're not too close together, not too far away. Like I was literally all up in this girl's face and she's just like, girl, let me do the piercing. Like, you know? So she pierced me up. It didn't hurt at all. It was swollen for a whole week and she put these like huge bars in my tongue so that when it does swell, because instead of just getting one, I was getting two at a time. So it was literally like my tongue was gonna either double the size or literally just be swollen like hell for so many weeks. So she put these long bars in my tongue and so I would bite on them from here and there and it would be painful to my teeth, but I never thankfully chipped any of my teeth or broken any of my teeth on any of the tongue rings that I've ever had. But the swelling didn't really stop me from eating a whole lot. I just ate a lot of cold stuff, stayed away from dairy, you know, things like that. I went back to downsize my bars to something more manageable for me. And you know, me and my girls have been great ever since. January 2019, I got my septum pierced as well as my Ashley pierced for the first time. The septum piercing pain was definitely like, I'd say a 4 out of 10, and the Ashley was like a 2 out of 10. It didn't hurt at all. If your lips are dry and crackly, I would recommend definitely like putting on some chapstick an hour or two before you go in, just so your lips are kind of, you know, moisturized, because that clamp, it's not gonna hurt, but it is gonna like make your lips even more ashy. So if you got ashy lips going into it, you're gonna have ashier lips coming out of it. And girl, you just got a new piercing, you can't put on no chapstick. All you can do is lick your lips a hell of a lot of times to get that ash going away. So I definitely recommend putting on some kind of chapstick. But the pain wasn't bad for either piercing. The healing was horrible for the septum, because instead of her getting my sweet spot in my nose, she actually pierced part of it through the skin, like right here on my nose, and the other part was actually through, you know, like between the cartilage and the skin. So like that little skinny piece that's not cartilage. I took it out like 3 days after having it in. It was not okay. But my Ashley piercing, I actually kept that in for a good 6 months, I think. I absolutely love that piercing. It was my favorite. It just got old really quickly. Like it wasn't like I was biting on it or anything. None of my teeth are chipped in the front, so I didn't have that to worry about. Plus I always looked at kind of how I ate, how I talked, how I did things, because I already have tongue rings. So it was like I just had another bar to watch out for in my mouth. So it was really easy to take care of the piercing. It just got old and it was just like, eh, kind of tired of having it, kind of bored, kind of want something new. So I took it out. Also in 2019, I went and got my nose pierced, a double piercing again. Basically, they were pierced too far apart. Like I had one way back here and one way up here, and I absolutely hated it. But you know, it wasn't painful because I already had my nose pierced, so I already kind of knew what to expect. And that was that. Also, I forgot to mention that in 2019, I got my nipples pierced. The pain wasn't bad, the healing wasn't bad, nothing was bad. In 2020, before, you know, everything kind of went to shit, I started on my ears. So I started stretching my ears on, I think it was like February something. So after that, I stretched until I reached an 8 gauge. And I reached an 8 gauge on Valentine's Day. And on the 17th, I went to a 6 gauge, and literally it was the worst stretch of my life. So I gave it some time, gave my body some time to like kind of take the shock of what just happened to my freaking earlobes. And I didn't stretch again until February 26th. But listen to your body at the end of the day. Your body's gonna tell you when it doesn't like something or when something's not working out. I think the only reason that I was able to stretch up so fast is because, one, those are the easiest stretches, and two, I wear hoops 24/7, so my ears are always being like way down. So then on the 29th is when I started getting piercings for my ears back to back to back. Just because I had a certain look that I wanted for my ears, and I wanted certain piercings that I, you know, thought of, but I didn't want to be one of those girls who like go on Pinterest and then like see all of the, you know, ear inspo and then just go send a picture and be like, I want my ear just like this. Like, no, I wanted to actually design my own ear, create my own ear piercing style, you know, and that's what I did. So on February 29th, I got my Rook and my Daith pierced. The Rook pain was like a 7, the Daith piercing was like a 4. Healing for the Rook was like it wasn't hard to heal it at all. The Daith, however, the ball kept coming out, so I had to keep going to different piercing shops to get it fixed. The people in my town that does piercings are absolute trash. They yanked at the piercing when I literally told him I just got it done like a few days ago, and he was just like, all right, yeah, cool. And I ended up getting a bump on my Daith piercing, so I had to do sea salt soaps twice a day, put tea tree oil on it. Like, I literally tried everything and the bump was not going away. So then I got both of my traguses done and the pain was like a 2. However, this one started to reject. So I then just took it out as well as this one and just like left them alone. But I do think I'm going to go and get them back. So on March 1st, I was sized up to a 2 gauge. And then by March 7th, my second hole was closed for my nose that I had let close. And I got it re-pierced. Pain was a 3, the healing was a 1, because at that point I already knew what to expect. Again, I already know what, you know, what I should do for healing. So it was pretty freaking easy. So then while I went to get my nose pierced, I actually went to get a double conch on each side, and that's just these right here. I don't know if y'all can see them. The pain was definitely, I'm not gonna say the pain was bad, but it was high, you know, to say that these piercings are like something that's so, you would think the skin is thin, you would think that it's gonna be easy, but I guess the angle or the clamp, I don't know, it was just something. But those things hurt like a bitch. It was like an 8. Pain 8. Healing was a 6 because I didn't get a Q-tip to go in between them. So it was literally like, it was just a bunch. It was just a bunch. Then we moved to a new house. So I didn't get any new piercings for I think like a week or so. But whenever I did go back, I went ahead and got my second lobes done. And then I went to get my helix, like one of my helixes done. And I remember when I got my helix done, like my ears swell up like a freaking bit. Like one of my ears were okay. One of my ears were not swollen at all, didn't have any problem, but the other one was like a big old balloon up here. It looked crazy. I was like, bro, like what am I gonna do? Like it just looks so crazy. And I was just hoping that nobody like noticed or anything, because I mean, piercings are gonna like swell, but at the same time, you don't expect them to swell up so much so to the point where people can notice it. So I was like, dang, like I really hope nobody sees this. I hope that, you know, we're just good. So then the next time I went in like March 21st, and I got everything that was on this side. So I got a Daith where I didn't have one, I got a Daith on, and whichever ear I didn't have a Rook on, I got a Rook. And I got my second helixes done and my third lobes. And then at that point, everybody was like shut down, quarantine started, nobody was doing piercings, nobody was doing tattoos, you know, everything kind of got quiet. So obviously I stopped getting piercings. I just kind of took some time to let the ones that I had heal, and most of them rejected. Some of them got bumps on them, but I tried to keep them as clean as possible, doing sea salt water soaks and, you know, just going around the jewelry, rotating the jewelry, making sure the balls are tight, things like that. So then whenever everything opened back up, I think it was sometime in like August, and I went and I got my Ashley piercing back. And like during the whole quarantine thing, like when everybody was shut down, my nose, like one of my nose piercings from the piercing place that I got done here, literally bumped over after having it for like 6 months. It like just got a huge bump over it, and it got so bad to where it literally like covered the piercing. So I took it out, let that heal, and then I went and got it re-pierced when I got my Ashley redone. And so I went to the next town over, got those two done, just like I got all my ears done, and we were good to go. Yeah, and the healing for both of those piercings were, I mean, I'd had them before, so it was pretty simple, pretty easy to take care of. The pain wasn't bad because I already knew what to expect. I do hope to get some of my ear piercings back because I started with so many of them and I absolutely loved every last one of them, and now I kind of just have like bare ears. I feel like my ears are just missing something. But yeah, you know, that's all I gotta say. That's all I really wanted to talk about was my piercings. So I hope you have a great little day, little night, little evening, whichever you're watching this on, whatever time, whatever place, whatever you're doing right now. I just hope that you enjoy and that you're watching my video all the way through. And if you did watch it all the way through, drop a fruit down below, and I will see y'all in my next one. Bye.